Hello everyone, welcome to the world of Lean Six Sigma. I am Mohit Sharma, your mentor and coach on Lean Six Sigma issues and problems. In our day-to-day life, we report data. And whenever we report data, we always are confused when to use mean or median when we represent or when we report data. So in this video, I am going to talk what is mean and what is median and when we can use mean or median in our data representation. Our central tendency of data can be measured by mean or median. The definition of mean is popularly known as an average and is representative of the center point of a sample. The correct measure of central tendency when the data is continuous and normal. So I will also talk about how to find out the normality of the data. Suppose you have to calculate the mean of the following numbers 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. The first step is to add these numbers. The sum of this is 70. Divide by the count of these numbers, which is 5. And the mean of this data set is 14. What is median? Median is the 50th percentile of a given data sample. And the correct measure of a central tendency when the data is continuous and normal or non-normal. So preferably when the data is non-normal, we will use median. And when the data is normally distributed, we will use mean. How to calculate median? If this is the data set on which you have to calculate the median, the first step is to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. And if it has odd numbers in it, so the center point is 14 here, which represents the median. If your data set has even numbers, like in this case 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, the average of the center two number is the median, which is 14 plus 15 divided by 2, which is 14.5. So dataset 2 has median of 14.5. So now it is very important when to represent mean and when to represent median for our dataset. Another point which I want to highlight. So for that, we will take an example to understand when to use mean and when to use median. Where to use median? Suppose an organization has decided to deduct standard tax of 15% from all manager salaries. And they are considering the average as the measure of central tendency. For example, this is the data from manager salary. Average is 1 lakh and the 15% tax is $15,000 per annum. That is what they are going to deduct. Irrespective of the salary of the manager, they will deduct a standard tax of 15%, which is $15,000. Now what happens? There is a mistake which has happened. Instead of 1 lakh in the last place, it has been typed as 5 lakh. What will happen? The average will go up in this case, which was 1 lakh earlier, but the average is 1,57,143 in this case. And 15% tax on that is $23,571. Now each manager has to pay $23,571, which is way above the tax which they were supposed to pay. So now if we use median here, what will happen? The data will be arranged into ascending or descending order. Either this 5 lakh will go at the top or at the bottom. So in our data set, it has gone to the bottom. The median of this data set is 1 lakh only. And now the standard tax would be $15,000 only. So whenever you have any outlier in the data set, you should use median. That is the takeaway from this particular example. So the outlier is, instead of 1 lakh, they have keyed in 5 lakh. When should we use median and when should we use mean? The conditions are, number one, data should be continuous. That is to be true for both mean and median. The data should be normally distributed when we use mean, and data should be non-normally distributed when we use median. Or in simple layman terms, when data has outliers, we should use median. Otherwise, we can use mean. So let us go to Minitab and understand how to calculate normality of the data. I have entered the data in Minitab.
To calculate normality, we will go to Stat, Basic Statistics and Graphical Summary.
Under Variables, we will double click on the first one, which is Salary, and we click OK. P-value in this graph is greater than 0.05, which represents that data is normally distributed, and hence mean can be used here. So now let me change the last value, which was point number 7 to 5 lakhs.
Let us repeat the same test. We can press Ctrl E to reach to the last screen in Minitab.
Under Variables, we will have Salary. and click OK. P-value of this data set is less than 0.05, hence data is non-normally distributed. Now we have to use median, which is 1 lakh in this case. So friends, let me conclude here. The mean is used when data is normally distributed and median is used when data is non-normally distributed. I hope you would have understood the difference. So with this, I come to the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you really like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share this video with your friends. I will see you in my next upcoming video pretty soon. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.